I got out of the car and I could see going across all three lanes this like S trail of a firewall that was about 6-7 feet tall. I mean, it was like something right out of Indiana Jones. It was crazy. And the fire trail went all the way up, straight up to the car, and I could see that the car was starting to get engulfed on the back as it was coming up on the hood. And I'm yelling into the car. I couldn't get any response from the person inside. You know, I don't know if this car's gonna explode or not. The gas tank obviously had a leak in it from the fuel, but fumes are what causes it to blow, and I didn't know if there was fumes in the gas tank, so I'm thinking, we gotta get this lady out of the car. So I grabbed this guy that was standing on the corner. I said, I need your help, come over here. And I gave him the rest of my fire extinguisher, and I said, I'm gonna get the door open. As soon as I open it, I need you to spray underneath the car to keep the flames out. So I manipulate the door, I finally get the door open, and he starts shooting the fire extinguisher underneath there, and I'm yelling at the lady. Now I can see it's an elderly lady. I'm like, you need to get out of the car, get out of the car. And she's just sitting there. Well, now the fire extinguisher is empty, and the flames are starting to come back up underneath the car. Now I got the open door, so I'm like, we gotta get her out of here. So I climbed in over the top of her and undid the seatbelt and grabbed her, and we yanked her out and drug her over to the curb away from the car. And she was just in a daze. She was completely unaware that her car was on fire and that she was locked inside it. My fear was that this lady was gonna either get burned alive and that we wouldn't be able to make it. I was scared. I mean, we could have got hurt, but that's what we do. But she ended up being well. They took her to the hospital, and as far as I know, everything turned out okay with her. And so I think it ended well.